Are you ready? Part 1. Let's watch.
Jennifer está em uma nova sessão de terapia com o Dr. Allen. Desta vez, ela quer falar sobre algumas relações pessoais do passado. Vamos ver do que se trata.
Dr. Allen, I'm very confused again. You're the only one who can help me.
Well, that's what I do, Jennifer.
I want to talk about Christopher, an ex-boyfriend of mine. I was only 15, he was 16. We dated for a year and a half, and then I never saw him again.
I see. So, you were 15 years old, and he was 16 years old.
That's right. You see, yesterday I was at my home with my best friend, watching a movie. And suddenly the phone rang, and it was him.
Him who?
Christopher. My boyfriend when we were teenagers.
Oh, yes, of course. So, were you in high school?
Yes. He was the perfect boy. My parents adored him. But to tell you the truth, I wasn't that interested. You see, I didn't have much fun with him.
No fun.
Yes, that's right. Well, when he called yesterday and asked me out, at first I was all happy and enthusiastic and said yes. Then I told my parents, and they were more enthusiastic than I was. But after that, I started to remember him better. We were completely different. We had nothing in common, really. So finally, I decided I did not want to go out with him. Now I think I accepted the invitation only to please my parents.
It's all about parents.
Yes, Doc, thanks.
That's what I do. So, let's move back to primary school.
Okay, then.
A terapia está trazendo a Jennifer lembranças de sua infância. E o Dr. Allen parece estar muito interessado pelo tema, não é verdade? Sigamos agora com a sessão Let's Talk.
Let's Talk. Sequence linkers.
Quando narramos alguma sequência, no passado, presente ou no futuro, podemos utilizar certos conectores que marcam o início, o meio e o fim da referida sequência. Veja este exemplo.
Yesterday, I followed the same routine as usual. First, I got up. Then, I took a shower. After that, I got dressed. And finally, I left my house.
Para indicar o início da sequência, utilizamos a palavra first, que significa primeiro. Às vezes, também podemos dizer first of all, que quer dizer em primeiro lugar.
First of all, we're going to travel to Italy.
Para seguir com seu relato, alguns dos conectores que pode usar são next, them ou after that, que querem dizer então ou depois.
First, I played tennis. Then I swam in the pool. Next, I cycled for an hour. After that, I had a big glass of beer.
E por último, vejamos como finalizamos a sequência utilizando finally.
Every day, when Rita arrives home, first she takes off her shoes. Then she watches some TV. After that, she has dinner. And finally, she goes to bed.
Agora que já tem mais elementos para contar uma história, sigamos estudando gramática. Vamos ver Grammar File.
Grammar File. Verb to be in past.
O verbo to be, que como você já sabe, significa ser ou estar, não segue a mesma regra dos outros verbos para formar o passado. Observe estes exemplos.
Yesterday afternoon, Jack was at home. The party wasn't very good. Were John Lennon and Paul McCartney from Manchester? No, they weren't. They were from Liverpool.
O passado do verbo to be fica was ou were conforme o pronome pessoal que é usado. Vejamos primeiro a forma afirmativa.
Am, is, was. Are, were. I was. You were. He was. She was. It was. We were. You were. They were.
O verbo to be é diferente dos demais verbos, já que suas formas negativa e interrogativa não se conjugam com o auxiliar. Simplesmente acrescenta-se not na negativa e se inverte a ordem sujeito-verbo na interrogativa. Vejamos primeiro alguns exemplos da forma negativa.
I wasn't. You weren't. He wasn't.
Observe agora como é invertida a ordem na forma interrogativa.
Was I happy? Were you happy? Was he happy?
Vejamos agora alguns exemplos.
I was very ill last month. Their children weren't at school at 6 p.m. yesterday. Was Kate at work in the morning? Yes, she was. No, she wasn't.
Você está curioso para saber como continua a sessão de terapia? Clique em Are You Ready? Part 2.